Question is it possible to experience a oneness? I am speaking and I am listening, or the tree is one with me. So now the perception is limited to the sense organs in the mind. Perception is possible only with limited sense organs mind. There is no perception possible in awareness, because awareness is everything.
Yes.
Correct, no?
Yes.
So now the awareness uses the body and mind as instrument. Correct, no? So now the mind has not expanded to infinity. The infinity what you feel is because mind has touched itself. Mind has become no mind, momentarily.
Mind has touched the awareness. Yes.
Okay? It has become no mind, momentarily.
Yes.
It has not settled there. If mind says moment totally settles there, there is no perception at all.
Sleep.
Turiya. Not sleep. Mind has touched momentarily and coming back. So when it comes back, it comes as limited only.
Yes.
But when it touches, the center is multiple. The center is everywhere.
There is no center.
No center and everywhere center means same thing.
No, everywhere center, there is a difference.
No, I am saying no center means everywhere. Self is nowhere and self is everywhere. Both mean same thing.
No, there is a difference, I think.
What is the difference?
No center means, it is nowhere. And self, when you say, so everywhere is limited.
No, self is this contradiction is not there in the self. It's contradiction in your mind only. Nowhere and everywhere is not possible in your mind. From self point of view, nowhere and everywhere both are possible. Contradictions are possible. Every perception self is there. That's why it's everywhere.
No, everywhere still feels like limited. Why no?
No, I'm saying.
Everywhere you are saying means.
No.
Or it is.
See, the Vedanta teaching is Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahman, and Brahman is nothing. First level, one level. It's called Nirvana. And second level teaching is Brahman is everything. That means everything is also there. So what we are saying, denying is Brahman being a limited being. So when you say everything, everything includes totality. So now that totality is not limited. Okay? Brahman is more than totality also. But this everything and nothing, both are simultaneously possible in Brahman.
Mm-hmm.
It's not either this or that.
Mm-hmm.
Brahman is nothing and Brahman is everything is simultaneously.
So these are our concepts again. Nothing and everything is also concept. So these are beyond that concept only. Brahman is beyond these both concepts.
No. Nothing and everything is for you to understand. Otherwise, there is
we know that we are talking from the language of mind. But from Brahman's point of view, this nothing, this everything.
Brahman point of view, we cannot speak anything.
Yeah.
Okay, if you want to speak from Brahman point of view, better keep it quiet.
Yeah.
Now only discussion is possible from our point of view.
Okay, so let us come back and you told.
So what happens is that's called Savikalpa Samadhi. Okay, Samadhi is two types, Nirvikalpa and Savikalpa. In Nirvikalpa Samadhi, what happens? Mind becomes no mind. Then there's no perception. It's like a deep sleep. But deep sleep is awareness. Okay, deep sleep and Nirvikalpa, there's a difference. Deep sleep is unconscious, Nirvikalpa is awareness but sleep. It's called Jagrata Sushupti. So there is no perception, there's no world. Okay, but Savikalpa is you momentarily go to Nirvikalpa and come back. Momentarily, it's a fraction of a time. Okay.
In the fraction of a second, what happens?
So in the fraction of a second, your center which was there is no longer there.
Okay.
Right? No longer there is a center. So then when it comes back, the center is there.
No. What do you feel like that?
No, in that time you cannot feel anything. No. Nirvikalpa, there is no feeling, no perception. No.
Okay.
Nirvikalpa, there is no feeling, no perception.
So when you told that, everything.
That's what I'm trying to tell you, explain to you. So there's a momentarily you are off, momentarily you are on. Okay, so that off and on, the ego off and on, that you perceive as oneness with your perception, the range of perception.
Range of perception.
Okay.
When you say range of perception, is it like now you are feeling like that means okay, this is your range.
Right.
Can it be total?
No, it is also total beyond, but the mind can only perceive and judge about the range of perception.
That is also limited.
No, that is a perception of the mind. That's not limited by the experience.
But perception of mind means this mind, the range, whatever range is there.
See, judgment and discussion happens with the mind. See, mind The self is everywhere, or all the places. The mind can, the mind when it comes back, it can only see this much. The sense organs and this thing is only this much. The answer, the understanding happens within that perception range. Okay? Then there are yogis whose perception range is beyond sense organs, who is called, what you call, mind has become much more sharper. So their range is perception. They feel, okay, I am also seeing somebody sitting somewhere. That is actually what called telepathy. Right? So this also I have experienced. So being able to see and perceive something beyond the range of sense organs also. Okay? That all it's the limitation of the mind. When it comes back, mind dissolves mentally in Savikalpa Samadhi and it comes back again, but it's now vasanas are changed now because it's touched the Savikalpa. So now it comes back not to the strong individual identity. The individual identity is weakened because it touched the self. So then what will happen when you perceive, everything is connected. Now if the mind has become subtler and sharper, the telepathy will happen. He'll see somebody sitting somewhere also. The range of the mind is increased. But all perceptions happen within the range of mind and sense organs, perceptions. Within that perception, the shifting will happen, understanding will happen.
But still, that is also unreal, no?
That's what I told you, no? I started to tell you with that only, no? That even that experience is unreal, that only finally you'll understand this is called what is called God experience.
But that helps in to break that current reality.
The current reality gets broken. The current reality breaks. That's what happened to me. That's exactly. Suddenly my reality, whatever reality which I experienced, it got suddenly got shifted, shattered.
So, again, next time again it happens?
No, now it's different. Now it's, all these are unreal. Now, when I speak to you, neither you are there nor I am there. The speaking is happening. There's no center.
Okay, so this on and off is not there, only off is there.
Only off is there.
Totally center has been dissolved. But
the functional center is there. To make the body function, it will be there. It's like you're woken up in the dream.
But that means you will never feel like that you are sitting in a chair or anything. So it is like that somebody is sitting in
the
chair.
The body is sitting. The body. You're aware that an object is there, body is there. That object is also unreal. The chair is also unreal as much.
Okay. And the activities you feel like you are doing are
happening.
It is happening. Like that. And this thought process, no, which we say is that, okay, now I am going to lift my hand. So I am going to take my cup and do.
There is no doer. Doing is there.
Thinking also not.
There is no thinker. The thinking is there.
Hmm. And doership. That ego?
Obviously, no. Obviously, when there is no doer, there is no doing. There is doing is there. Okay. There is no perceiver. The perception is there. Perceiving is there.
So there is no feeling of surrender also. Because
to whom to surrender? Whom to surrender?
And who is going to surrender?
Hmm? But when you talk, you will tell people that, okay, surrender to God, you will say.
That is also not you. No,
that is for communication purpose.
Okay, but there is no effort in that.
Effort. There is no surrender. There should be somebody to surrender, no?
No, to say something also, to explain everything you don't know.
Yeah.
There is no effort in that.
There is no effort, no? Explanation happens because of the pending vasanas. Their programs are, pending programs are running. Mm-hmm. Now, why I am talking to you, their pending programs are there. Mm-hmm. The pending programs will talk to another pending program. Mm-hmm.
So, it's not sticky with the vasanas, it is just loosened.
Loosening.
Like Ashtavakra, even blinking my eyes also, I feel the effort, to do effort for that purpose. So this is happening totally. Okay.